here on TV5.
You know, this is a wonderful Christmas party. What could possibly happen to spoil it?
Nothing.
Nothing.
Nothing could go wrong.
Listen, wait a minute. Hold. I've got a news scoop right now that just came in. Even Larry Martell does not have this. I'm telling you, this is late-breaking news, and it's of interest to every single one of you, so pay attention. Western Union Telegram, a telegram from Santa Claus.
Santa Claus.
Ooh, all right.
Dear kids, I've decided to retire. I feel after 936 years, it's time. So my last Christmas will be this December 25th. Oh, wait, it continues. Rather than replace me, I think they will probably just do away with the position. Signed, Santa. Blockbuster. I mean, we're talking Thunderbolt here.
What?
What's the real reason? I mean, Santa just retiring? There's got to be more to it than that. What? He wasn't feeling good. It's his health.
No, no. Isn't it enough that after 936 years, the guy, he probably never took a vacation in his life. It's time.
I don't know. This just doesn't sound right.
It doesn't.
Did it have anything to do with Santa Claus barbecue sauce endorsement?
Just buy it as it is on the paper. All right? My understanding is the management of the Merchants Association jumped at the... accepted this with regrets.
His contract had another 900 years to go.
Mr. Wallace, you're making a much bigger deal out of this than is necessary. Listen, look at it. It says, I'm retiring. It's over. Santa signed it. It's enough. Just accept it for what it is.
Wait a minute. Look at that. The writing.
The handwriting.
This is Gerald's handwriting. This whole thing is a hoax.
A hoax? What should we do with this telegram, Gary? That's what we're doing.
Happy New Year!
Sit down and finish your cereal. We'll be back in a minute.
Told you we'd come back.
Yes, it's time for the annual Christmas party on the Wallace and Ladmo Show. Fireman Bob, Officer Doug, Officer Steve, and Andy from the museum have already shown up. We're expecting others as time progresses. Yeah. But right now, help yourself to some punch, grab some cookies. Ladmo and Jody and I have to excuse ourselves to go over into the audience to find winners.
Okay.
I'm ready.
Hold the fort, guys. And to expedite matters on finding the location of these winners, I have a seating chart. And with the aid of that seating chart, we will find our first winner who will receive...
A lot of good stuff. A Ladmo bag with a lot of Christmas stuff in there, too, won't we?
All right. Today we have packed 463. We have a group from the Lutheran Church and some Boy Scouts, Brownie Troop, 929.
556, Cub Scouts.
And a lot of wonderful moms and dads that brought the kids down. All right, now, Ladmo, as you go up that center aisle, I want you to go up there to your left, the fourth row.
One, two, three, four.
The third seat in.
One, two, three. What is your name?
Yeah.
Phillips, our winner. There he is. All right.
Okay. Okay. Jody, what have you got?
Puppet Christmas stocking, isn't this cute?
And
so, some tickets to see the dinosaur exhibit at the Science Museum.
You are looking at a dinosaur. All right, Jody, I want you to go up that center aisle all the way to the top row.
Okay, to the top.
To your right, four heads over.
Four, what is your name?
Jonathan.
Well, Jonathan, that's all yours. You win.
And now, Jody, Ladmo, back over to the main set to see who has shown up for the party. Why, Nurse Jeannie's here in her Christmas sweater. Hi, Jeannie, how are you?
I'm fine.
All right. Hold it just a second. Let's see who that is.
Oh, my goodness.
Never mind, Nurse Jeannie in her Christmas sweater. I mean, you're a nice lady, but how about Aunt Maud in her Christmas shawl, huh?
Aunt Maud, it wouldn't be a Christmas party without you. We're delighted to see you, and Merry Christmas.
And it wouldn't be a Christmas party without Fireman Bob one-upping everybody, trying to get in on the close-ups. I brought Christmas cookies for everyone.
Oh, wonderful.
How about that?
Oh, you did.
Huh?
I like these little ones that you make like trees.
Yes. Did you ever ask me what that green stuff was?
I was afraid to.
Don't.
All right. Okay, thank you so much. We have another Christmas cartoon for you. The party proceeds.
Where's my Milli Vanilli album?
Where's your Christmas story?
Commercial time.
Back to the show.
Well, we're right in the middle of our Christmas party, and I'm trying to figure out who brought what. These came from Jody. Nurse Jeannie brought these. Patsy Kwiatkowski brought these. And, hey, a lot of neat stuff here. So you really should be pouring yourselves a cup of punch. Dave, the scientist, just showed up. Have some cookies.
We figure he can mix it all.
We'll take this box out and pass it out to the kids. Speaking of the kids, Lad has some winners, some Ladmo bag winners that he wants you to meet right now. So let's go over and see what's going on.
We have lots of winners. Let's meet them real quick. Hi, now, what's your name?
This is Ryan.
Hi, Ryan, and you are?
Joe.
Hi, Joe. Thanks for bringing Ryan down here. Now, we have some more winners over here. What is your name?
Jennifer.
Hi, Jennifer. And?
Nicole.
Next, Nicole?
Sarah.
And you are?
Matthew.
Who's that on the end? What is your name?
Kevin.
Kevin. Hi, Kevin. Another row of winners. What's your name?
Janelle.
Another row of winners. Way on top over here.
Sam.
What is it again?
Sam.
There he is. And?
Andy. Dan.
Richard.
Anthony.
And?
Scott.
Okay, they've got Ladmo bags filled with lots and lots of Christmas stuff and good things. Excuse me right now.
Thank you very much. Nice hat, Andy.
Hey, thanks.
What is it?
It's a McDowell pattern forage cap from 1858. It's actually a replica. And it was General McDowell that McDowell Road in Phoenix was named after. And this is the kind of hat that he wore.
What's with the red tape?
Oh, the red tape. You heard about cutting through red tape? Well, this red tape, the government used on everything. They put it around all their documents. And to speed things up, you'd cut through the red tape instead of untying it.
Great. Have you had some cookies? Nurse
Jeannie, I'm going to have some more.
Have some apple cider. Okay, let's get going now with our next Christmas. Wait a minute, hold it.
At the door. Who's that?
Oh,
Marshall Good.
Marshall Good, what did you bring to the Christmas party?
Something that's very precious to me.
Mm-hmm.
A paper bag.
Oh, paper bag.
But don't laugh just a second. You know what you can do? You can blow this up and make noises. And you can put it on your head if you're embarrassed about your football team.
How does it work?
What?
How does it work? Does it come with directions?
Oh, no. Watch. This is really the exciting part.
Wow.
You do this, and people put stuff in it.
How about Cruz Chicken?
No. No, I know better than I ask you. Boys and girls, your allowance, any little change, a spare change.
Goes over to the audience.
Well, it's about time. Back to Wallace and Ledimo.
Do we get some of the apple cider and juice and stuff out to the moms?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah,
we have some more cookies. Now, how do you pronounce this, Ledimo?
Krusticky.
Boy, are they good.
Let me have one of those.
Crunch, crunch, crunch.
Pass those this way.
All right. Debbie, why don't you try one of these?
Oh, yeah.
The Wallace and Ledimo Christmas party continues.
Yes.
We're having fun, and we hope that you're enjoying your Christmas and you're having happy holidays. And we have yet another Christmas cartoon.
I'm ready.
Wait a minute.
Hold it. Someone's out there. Well, who could be? I hit.
Captain Super.
Want to see me break a pretzel?
What is that?
Want to see me break a pretzel with salt?
No.
What did you... What did you bring for the Christmas party? What did you bring?
Oh.
Everybody.
You've got a tree.
Yeah.
Right?
Well, what did you make?
Joe, crew, dump the tree. You can toss that out.
Huh?
I've got the most exciting Christmas decoration of all. And I'm sorry, gang, there's only one, and it has to be for this party, this set. Wait, I've got it right out here.
Instead of a Christmas tree?
You'll never want a tree again when you've got this.
Really? All right. This got to be good.
Something to put the presents around, hand decorations on.
Take the place of a Christmas tree.
And this is...
This is... a life-size statue of Captain Super. Authentic, absolutely remarkable, and boys and girls, I wish that I could make this available. Actually, I suppose I could have duplicates made. How about $2,500 apiece? Talk to your mom and dad about a second mortgage and send to Super Statue, care of TV.
You honestly thought we were going to put this up instead of the Christmas tree and put the presents around the bottom?
Well, doesn't it seem appropriate?
Let's let the kids decide.
Huh?
How many want the statue of Captain Super instead of a Christmas tree? Not one among you?
No.
So, how many want to go with the tree?
Yeah!
Wait a minute, that could go either way.
Are you kidding? Take your cardboard replica and adios.
All right, in the spirit of Christmas, thank you very much.
All right.
See, I'll go to Sharper Image.
Cartoon Man. Sandy, nice to see you.
Thank you. Nice to see you.
Got
all right. Room. Okay. Sure. Now, Wed, are you set for your annual traditional rendition of Little Drummer Boy?
I'm ready. I'm going to go on the Drummer Boy set. Okay, get ready for it.
All right, they got a mic all set up for last to narrate. Here we go with Little Drummer Boy.
I'd like to tell you my favorite Christmas story about the little drummer boy. It was a long time ago in a place far away when everyone heard that a king had been born. Now this wasn't just any king. It was the child the world had been waiting for many, many years. So they came. They came to see this baby, bringing to him the gifts they felt a king deserved. They brought jewels and gold and many other treasures. And they waited and watched and worshipped. But there was one who waited outside. One who had no gift to offer the newborn infant. It was a poor little drummer boy who had come very far just to see him. But now, how could he? How? With nothing. But his drum. Why, that's it. After all, he was a drummer boy, and why shouldn't he offer what was his only gift? He would play his drum for his king, and he did play. He played his drum, and played, until the baby smiled at him and his drum.
That was great.
That was great, wasn't it?
Yeah.
We liked it, Landmo.
Yeah. Yeah,
is that okay?
That was terrific.
Oh, thank God. That's my favorite.
Now, to all of our regulars,
uh-huh.
All everybody here, Doug and Steve and Andy and all the rest, and Dave and Jeannie, your Ladmo bags from Ladmo are over here under the Christmas tree.
Yes,
grab your Ladmo bags, because we're all going to sing
a Merry Christmas
carol.
All right.
Yeah. All right, here we go.
Jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in one horse open sleigh. Jingle bells, jingle all the way.
Gone. I thought that stupid party was going to last forever. All right. Now I can put my presents under the tree from Wallace for Wallace and Ladmo. As always, no signature, nothing for them to suspect that I gave in to this sentimentality. Let me see if I've got it right. Jenny Craig quits the business for Wallace, and English for the monolingual for Ladmo. Hey! You stop your spying on me. Don't you dare tell Wallace and Ladmo who left those presents. It's none of your business and none of their business either. Do you understand? I don't believe in any of this. Santa doesn't come to my house. I don't need anything. I can buy anything I want. So for the rest of you little twerps who believe, just go right ahead and have one of your middle-class Christmas celebrations. You can do it without me. Goodbye. Okay. Merry Christmas, everybody.